Somebody apprehend that man at once.
You're coming with me, boy. And I don't want any trouble.
Inspector. A moment, please.
Just what do you think you're doing? This man poses an imminent threat to our national security.
I cannot deny the damage that Clive has done to our city. But we can't forget that he's also a victim of a political agenda for progress, no matter the cost.
You've got some nerve, man.
Professor, I...
Answer me one question, Clive. You knew full well I'd stand in the way of your plot, so why did you send for me?
Dimitri was sure he needed you for his project, but I knew full well of the threat you posed to my plan. Though I suppose I still led you all the way to the heart of my base, didn't I? At first I was just toying with you, but at some point I realized I was enjoying our time together. Maybe part of me wanted somebody to save me from my all-consuming madness. As you did, all those years ago.
I need to go back! My parents are still inside!
Pull yourself together, boy! There's nothing to be done. Jump back in there, and you'll die too.
No! Oh, no!
That was you.
Deep down inside, I hoped you might be able to talk me down from the edge of insanity again. This is the second time you've saved my life now. Thank you. Don't worry about me. I intend to atone for my crimes. I look forward to the day we meet again. Until then, I hope life treats you well, Professor.
And you too, Clive.
Barton, take him back to headquarters.
Yes, sir!
Criminals like him make me think the whole world has gone mad. Despicable. Just despicable.
Yes, people can often be so blinded by their own motivations that they lose sight of the damage they do. But criminals aren't the only blind ones.
Just what are you implying, Inspector?
Nothing at all. Just stating a fact, sir. Now, if you'll excuse me, I still have work to do.
I don't know what to say when I think of all the suffering I caused in the name of research.
It was terrible. But I see you must have loved Claire very much to do what you did.
The more I reflect on it, the more unsure I am as to whether it was love or pride that compelled me. For 10 long years I chased after what so many called impossible. But you know, Herschel, there is one detail that you got wrong.
What are you referring to?
I don't think I have much longer here, Herschel.
I don't know what you mean.
You've taken awfully good care of that hat I gave you.
What did you say?
Oi, there you are, Layton. I did a background check on Claire's family like you asked. There's no record of Claire having a younger sister.
Then...
Yes, it was quite a shock when I first worked it out.
But you can't really mean...
It's me, Herschel. It's Claire.
While it defies logic, it seems the experiment 10 years ago wasn't a complete failure. Somehow Claire was shot 10 years into the future.
To our present.
Yes, the time machine worked. If only for that single moment before it exploded.
That's not possible.
Unfortunately, however, there were more complications. Shortly after appearing in the present, Claire's body showed signs of molecular instability. It was trying to return to its own time. I attribute that phenomenon to the incomplete nature of the time machine. She didn't have long here. I worked on the machine in the hopes of finding a way to stabilize her existence in the present. But it seems inevitable that she'll return to her own time, to the moment of the blast.
I begged Dimitri to stop his work. Tampering further with time can only result in more anomalies. There's no telling what chaos we'd release upon the world if we tried to save the dead from their fate. The flow of time must remain linear. We all know the consequences of changing its course. But Dimitri wouldn't listen to me. That's when I knew the only way to stop him was through you, Herschel. What Dimitri, Bill, and I did 10 years ago broke the laws of nature. And now we must pay.
This is all so incomprehensible.
It's time to end this already, Dimitri.
Yes, it does seem that way. My research has threatened our very existence, and it could do so again. Tonight, I will close the book on the time machine forever.
I suppose this is it, Herschel. I have to go back to my own time. Back to that day when we parted.
No, Claire.
I'm sorry, I can't stay.
Claire, wait!
We had so many plans for the future. Do you remember, Herschel? I'll miss you. And our unwound future.
You can't go! I don't want to say goodbye again. I can't. I won't.
I know you. And I know you'll stay strong. After all, that's what a gentleman does. I must go now, Herschel. Thank you for everything. Goodbye.
Thank you.
gone.